Hello everyone, I am Sai, and in this video we are going to talk about how different celestial bodies appear to move in the sky when viewed from different locations on Earth. So let's start with the very basic term, horizon. This word actually has a Greek origin, which means limiting circle. So it is actually defined as an apparent boundary where the sky seems to meet the ground or the sea. So in this picture, you can see this line where apparently we see that the sky is meeting the ground is the horizon. It is also defined as a plane that is tangential to the Earth's surface at that particular point. So imagine that you are standing on this ground with, and there is nothing to obstruct your view. There are no buildings, there are no trees, and what you see is just the boundary where the sky meets the ground. Okay. Now, how will this boundary look like? So when you look around you, it will be in a shape of a circle. So it will be a circular boundary, and you will be standing at the center of this circle. An interesting question to ask is, how will this boundary look like from space? So let's imagine that you are standing at the North Pole of Earth, and on this huge ground where there is nothing again to obstruct your view, there are no buildings, there are no trees, and you are looking around you at this boundary, and your friend, he goes into the space and he wants to observe you on the Earth. So this is an interesting question, that how will he visualize your horizon? It will be something like this. So your friend will see you on the Earth, and the horizon as seen by him, by definition, and also as seen in the picture, will be a plane that is tangential to the Earth's surface at that particular point. Now let's say you go and stand on the equator. Then this will be your horizon. And in the intermediate locations, the horizon will depend on which latitude you are at, and again it will be a plane that is perpendicular to the Earth's surface at that particular point. So now again, going back to that same ground where there is nothing to obstruct your view and you see a beautiful horizon, another interesting question would be, how far is this horizon? So in this figure, you have a person of height small h standing on the ground. So distance from the center of the Earth would be capital R plus H, and he is looking around himself towards the horizon. So the distance to the horizon is small l. Small s is actually the length of the arc of the Earth. So by basic trigonometry and Pythagoras theorem, you can see that this equation will simplify to, the arc length s is equal to under root of 2 capital R into h. Now here we have made a basic assumption that small h, the height of the person, is very, very less than the radius of the Earth. For simplification and back of the envelope calculation, you also have a simplified version of this formula, which says this s, or the distance to the horizon, is 3.6 into root of h, where h is the height and it is in meters, and this entire quantity will be in kilometers. So, for example, I go into the sea and I am standing on a ship and I am looking around me. The distance to the horizon, the distance to the apparent boundary that I see would be 3.6 into root of, say, an average, a height of an average person, let's say it's 2 meters. So, 3.6 into root 2, which comes approximately to about 5 kilometers. So, an interesting outcome of this formula is that as h increases, your s will also increase. So whenever you go out in the night for a night sky observation, you might be interested in knowing the directions. So as you all know, the Earth is rotating around the axis, a fixed axis that is called the rotational axis. And this axis is actually pointing towards the star, which we called as the pole star or Polaris. So in the northern hemisphere, we are lucky enough to have a star which is aligned with our rotational axis. In southern hemisphere, that is not the case. Yes. So finding the pole star will help us to find the north direction. But how and where will this pole star be seen if we are at different locations on Earth? So let's say we go back to the north pole of the earth and we try to find the pole star. So where will we see it? And on the north pole, if you look above in the sky, the pole star will be exactly above you at zenith. Now let's see how it looks like in the sky. So imagine you are at the north pole, you are lying on a ground and you are looking up at the sky. So this is how the sky will look like, and the pole star will be right on the top of your head at zenith. Now let's go to the equator. Now how will a person standing on the equator see the pole star, or where exactly in the sky will he see it? So you have the earth, which is tilted at 23.5 degrees, and our observer is standing at the equator. So let's see from the observer's perspective where the pole star will be. So obviously the pole star is going to be on the horizon, and that point will be the north direction for that person. So our observer is on the equator and he is looking at the north direction. This is how the pole star will look like. It will be just at the horizon. So now we have seen pole star for where the pole star will be seen at the pole and at the equator. What about the intermediate locations on earth? So for all the intermediate locations, 0 degree latitude to 90 degree latitude, the height of the pole star, it will depend on the latitude from where you are observing it. So let's say our observer is at some intermediate latitude, which is phi, then the pole star will also be at an altitude of 5 degrees in the sky. So this helps us to come to an interesting observation, that is, the altitude of the pole star in the sky will be equal to the latitude of the place. So this is a picture taken from the Mumbai city, which is in India, and the latitude of Mumbai is around 19 degrees north. So as you can see, the pole star is also at certain altitude from the ground, which is equal to 19 degrees. So now we have seen where we will see the pole star in the sky from different locations on the earth. What about the motion of the stars? So will the stars appear to move differently when viewed from different places? So let's find out. So we go back to the north pole and we lie down on the ground and we start looking at the sky. The pole star is obviously at the zenith, at the top of our head. And what we will see? So we will see all the stars going around the pole star forming concentric circles. They will go round and round, they will neither rise nor set. They will always be there in the sky. So these stars are called as never setting stars. Now obviously all the stars which are below the horizon, they will be never rising stars for a person at the north pole. Now let's see what will happen at the equator. You go on the equator, we know that pole star will be right at the horizon. So all stars will rise and set, forming concentric arcs around the pole star. Now for any intermediate latitude, let's take the example of Mumbai again. We have pole star at a certain altitude from the ground, right? All the stars will rise and set again, forming concentric arcs about the pole star. But here, as you can see, interestingly, some stars which are there in this part of the sky, they will always be going around the pole star. They will never rise nor set, and these set of stars are called as circumpolar stars. Now this altitude, as we know, is equal to the latitude of the place. So you are observing from Mumbai, the latitude is 19 degrees. So obviously the altitude of pole star is 19 degrees. So all the stars at an angle of about 19 degrees from the pole, lying in this circle, in this region, they will never rise nor they will ever set. They will always be there in the sky, and those are called as circumpolar stars. Rest all the stars, as you can see in this video, they will rise and they will rise at east and they will set in the west. So one interesting observation to note is that obviously all stars are going in concentric paths around the pole star, and also the paths of two stars, they never intersect each other, they are always parallel. Okay. So now we have seen how different stars appear to move in the sky from different locations on the earth. But we have missed out on an important star being in the solar system, the sun. So, like any other star, the sun will also move in the sky, forming a concentric path, concentric circle around the pole star. But this will be its daily motion. It will rise at east, it will set in west, forming a concentric arc. But we also know that the sun, it also moves along the ecliptic. So you might be familiar with this picture. We have Earth at the center, we have the celestial sphere, we have the equator, and we have an ecliptic which is intersecting the equator at two points, that is vernal equinox and autumnal equinox, which is just behind the Earth. Now we know that sun is moving along this ecliptic. Starting from vernal equinox, it enters into the northern hemisphere, that is north of the celestial equator, goes to the northernmost point, which is the summer solstice, starts descending along the ecliptic, reaches autumnal equinox, goes into the southern hemisphere to the southernmost point, and then back at the vernal equinox. Now this entire journey takes 1 year, okay. So 360 degrees, this is obviously 360 degrees divided by number of days in the year, 365. So the sun on an average moves at a speed of 1 degree per day on the ecliptic. But how can we see this motion in the sky? Do we see it or not? So this motion of the sun along the ecliptic can be best seen as the change in the sunrise or the sunset point of sun in the sky. We might have observed that every day sun rises at different point from the horizon. So this is a picture, this is obviously a screenshot taken from the stellarium for a person who is standing at the equator on 21st March, that is the vernal equinox day, that the sun is rising exactly at the eastern point on the horizon. Now after vernal equinox, the sun starts moving more and more towards the north of the celestial equator till it reaches the northernmost tip, that is our summer solstice. So after that vernal equinox day, the sun will move more and more towards the north, and this is the position for the summer solstice where it is at the northernmost point. After summer solstice, that is 21st of June, the sun will start going again towards the south or southern direction till it reaches the southernmost point, that is the winter solstice. So this is a picture of again sunrise taken at the equator on 22nd of December. So as we saw that the sunrise and the sun or the sunset point, it changes daily. So this is a picture which is featured in the astronomy picture of the day in, I think, January 2022. This is actually a set of 13 pictures which is taken every month of the sunrise from a city in Canada. So the first picture was taken in December 2020, the last picture was taken in December 2021. So as you see, every month the point from which the sun rises, it changes. So this brings us to the end of this video. In this video we saw how the stars appear to move when looked at from different locations on Earth, and also how the sun, the motion of the sun along the ecliptic looks like from as viewed from Earth. Thank you.